And in particular, it was pointed out that he is a brilliant student of mathematics. At that time, I was a student under a professor of Inouye-Mann, working on finite groups. But I couldn't imagine that I shall have any kind of personal contact with the person in the newspaper. Several months later, sitting in the class of professor of Inouye-Mann, we observed that there is a new student here. He was not really a student, but he appeared in the class. And at the end of the lesson, Professor of Inouye-Mann introduced Ilya, and in a later time he told us that he constructed a counterexample to a very, very important conjecture, the dimension subgroup conjecture, and this was by a finite group, which was the subject of the course. Later, I knew, and Ilya knew me, more and more, deeper and deeper, and Ilya came to us. I went to Ilya and had the opportunity to enjoy his very warm and his wife's very warm hospitality. And in fact, Ilya explained me many of his works and other things, and introduced me to small cancellation theory, which is now the subject that I am working on. I'm very grateful to Ilya for this and for other things, and congratulate in the occasion of his birthday. I am late a few days, I think 3 days, but still, it is very happy. Thank you. Okay, so now I would like to come to my talk, which is of course on small cancellation theory. I usually work on the non-positive curvature part of small cancellation theory with combinatorial tools, I mean not hyperbolic and not geometric tools. And this is also the content of the talk of today. So it is accepted, widely accepted, that if we have a word which is long and complicated, then the one relator group it generates or relates is a small cancellation. Let us call such words small cancellation words. Now, I would like to show here that if a word does not happen to be small cancellation, it still has the opportunity to be small cancellation in a generalized sense, provided that it is non-small cancellation in a complicated and long way, when it is possible, and there are other cases when this is not possible. And the main point is that the cases for which such a construction is not possible consist of a finite computable class of word schemes. Now, by word scheme, I mean the following. We have, say, a squared, b cubed, a minus 3, or something like this, where a, b, and a, again, the same A, are words, and I can substitute for these words. Yes, and the number of such word scheme must be finite because of the method which I would like to describe. Today we shall not see the classification of this type because, according to what I did, for a certain case that I am going to talk about, there are no such exceptions. So what is this generalized small cancellation condition? Before I give a precise proof of the formulation of this notion, I just would like to say that this generalized small cancellation condition is related to the usual small cancellation condition in a similar way as abelian groups and solvable groups are related. Namely, we have a sequence. In this case, it will not be a sequence of subgroups, normal subgroups, but it will be a sequence of partitions of diagrams. And each layer here, each quotient, is abelian. And in our case, each quotient will be small cancellation, or in the general case, it will belong to a class, small class, of groups. So each such quotient belongs either to small cancellation in the usual sense, or it belongs to a class of groups which will be computed by this method. So the idea is, this is a very common idea, to form the product of several conjugates of the relator and declaring that they are defining relators. This way, we get an infinite presentation, which started with a single relation, which has this property. Now, of course, this is not a new method. Monsterology has this as one of the most basic technique, but there are some very essential differences. First of all, in the case of monsters, we can choose our parameters, numerical parameters, as high as we wish. And in our case, we cannot choose anything. The parameters are given, and we have to adjust the small cancellation theory to the parameters and not the parameters to the small cancellation condition. And second, both applications of this construction use verb combinatorics and also the geometry of diagrams. In the case of monsters, of course, most of the work is with the diagrams. This is the this is the main difficulty. However, in the case of what I am doing, the main work, almost all the work, is by word combinatorics. So, in fact, this talk could be also called an application of word combinatorics to one relator groups, because most of the work is word combinatorics. So let us now say something more precisely. We assume n greater or equal to a natural number x set of generators. For us, it will be a set of generators. And we have a presentation PR. We take this set x, and we have a set of subset of fx. In our case, we shall have only one relator, and I shall denote this relator by R, so I shall just write R belongs to fx. And this is a one relator presentation. I shall almost not work with groups, but only with presentations. Now, I of course assume that R is the cyclic, is the symmetric closure. And the R is cyclically reduced. Now, I just want to recall, I don't think I have to do it, I shall just write down. We have the CP condition. Everybody knows what it is. And we also have the TQ condition. On diagrams, say one Kampen diagrams, just to recall, this means in the language of diagrams that each inner region has at least p neighboring regions, and this means that each inner vertex has valency at least q. These are the notation, and then if n is a diagram, always it will be one Kampen connected in interior, one Kampen diagram. I shall denote by region of M the set of regions. See the M. Now, our basic assumption is that our one relator presentation doesn't satisfy any small cancellation condition. So, let us write this. H1 PR does not satisfy, I shall, for simplicity, the condition C6. You're working small cancellation conditions in the classical literature are the condition C6 or the condition C4 and T4. I shall work mostly with C6, but I shall have to mention also C4 and T4. The PR does not satisfy C6. So we can write it in a different way. We define M naught of R, of a word R, to be the minimum in the number of neighbors of a region where D is inner region of M. So we consider all the diagrams for Wankhammen diagrams over R, R diagrams over F, sorry, and we take for each of them, we consider all the regions inside and check how many neighbors it has, and the minimum of this number will be denoted by M0 of 2. So our assumption here is that this number is less than 6. Now I shall assume that R is not a proper power. R is not proper power. And then I know that M0 of R is either 2, 3, 4, or 5. So I have to deal with the case. I want to see how can I upgrade the small cancellation situation with a word which is not small cancellation. It certainly will not be small cancellation, but it could be still small cancellation in a weaker sense. In this talk, I shall assume, that M naught of R is 2. So this is the smallest case. And I also assume, this for simplicity, that R is, this is 1, and 2, R is a positive word. This is not really needed, although the final result that I'm going to formulate here could be not true when R is non-positive, but the method is exactly the same, a positive word. Okay, so before I formulate the theorem that I want to mention here, I want to formulate what I mean precisely by the generalized small cancellation condition. I noted here M0, hinting that there is also an M1 and an M2 and an M3 up to M5. And what the idea is to introduce deeper parameters, mi of r, I equals 2, 3, 4, 5, such that if each of them is large enough, big enough, then the diagram is generalized small cancellation. This is one thing, and if one of them is not large enough, then the word R belongs to a finite set of word scheme, computable finite set. We shall see that it is easy to compute them. Essentially, finite set of word scheme. Okay, so we start with a diagram M, and we want to consider partitions of the diagram to subdiagrams, such that each subdiagram is the interior of each subdiagram is homeomorphic to an open disk. Why you want to do this? Because if we can do this, we may consider these subdiagrams as regions of the big diagram. So let us start with the diagram given. So this is the generalized small cancellation condition. Let M be an RF diagram. This is shorthand notation for an R diagram over F. This will be important for the coming explanation, because I shall change R and I shall change F. So this is a diagram. This means that we have a labeling function from M into F. Yes, labeling function. When I change F, then it will be from M or some variant of M to another one. Denote, let pi of M be the set of all the partitions of M into disk diagrams, disk subdiagrams. So I mean by this that the interior of each part is homeomorphic to an open disk. So if this is N, what is a partition? It will be a partition to subdiagrams, something like this. And I require that each subdiagram is, as I draw here, the interior is homeomorphic to an open disk. So there are two trivial partitions. One of them, the partition of the diagram to the original regions, and one of them, the even more trivial partition, when there is exactly one part, and this is the whole diagram, and it is a disk subdiagram. So let us denote these diagrams, these partitions, by sigma naught and sigma t, t for terminal, sigma naught partition by diagrams, by the regions, and sigma t, or terminal sigma t, only one part, it is M. Now, we say that the group is, the representation is small cancellation if the sigma t is small cancellation relative to sigma naught, meaning that if I choose the regions, the elements of the partition sigma naught, then M will be, sigma t will be small cancellation relative to it. We want to extend this notion by inserting several other partitions between sigma naught and sigma t. So for a sigma 1 is a partition, say, by delta 1 to delta r, and sigma 2 partition by gamma 1 gamma s, we shall write that two partitions. We shall write that sigma 1 is smaller than sigma 2 if sigma 1 induces a partition on the parts on the gamma I. So we have a partition like this. This is, say, sigma 2. And now we have another partition, which is finer. So we never have something that this is one part. This is not allowed. In fact, every part of sigma 1 is either is inside one of the, precisely inside one of the parts.
What do you mean by refinement?
Sorry?
By refinement.
Refinement, exactly. This is exactly a refinement. And what I write here is just a kind of graded diagram, but the reason for the grading is different from the usual way it is used. So, now I define what I mean by generalized small cancellation condition. Definition. M satisfies a generalized small cancellation condition. If there is a sequence of partitions starting with sigma naught and ending with sigma terminal, sigma 1, sigma t, such that sigma I plus 1 is small cancellation relative to sigma I. By this I mean that each part of sigma I plus 1 considered as a diagram over the parts of sigma I is a small cancellation diagram. Small cancellation I shall mean usually it is C6. And now I can formulate the main theorem, which is the following. Let PR be a one relator test. Suppose that R is positive. Positive word. If P does not satisfy the condition C3, then the condition C3, then every R diagram over F is a generalized small cancellation diagram. One cancellation diagram. This is not true even with positive words for C4. There are immediate examples showing that this is not so, but the method is the same. is much more work. So how to prove this theorem? Of course, the point is how to define the sequence of partitions. So what is the, how we find the, how to find the reason that such a sequence of partitions exist. Sketch of the proof. We are going to show that there exists a sequence of length at most 6, sigma naught is not difficult, sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3, sigma 4, sigma 5. In fact, we do not have so long in general, but this, the most general case is, for the most general case, it is 5. Such that sigma I plus 1 is small cancellation, in fact, I can say more, is C6 relative to C sigma I. This is true for I greater or equal 1, and sigma 1 has a sigma 1 is a parts of sigma 1 are thin. By this I mean that no inner vertices, which is the other way to say that the dual is a tree. So we have, at the beginning, we have, this is the first step in the resolution. We have a tree-like diagram, something like this, without inner regions, or the inner vertices, sorry. And these are the regions of a bigger diagram. And here, it is a very strong, of course, small cancellation condition, because every small cancellation condition is trivially satisfied for a tree-like diagram. And then we have a diagram for which these are the regions. And that diagram is C6. If I consider these as regions, and so on, I can do it according to this. So what is the basic observation? There are, in fact, two basic observations. One of them is that we can write down a set of equations to say that a group is not small cancellation. Why is this? Suppose in the case of one relator group, so this is the first observation. Being a piece, can be expressed by word equations. So why is this? It's very simple. Suppose that we have two regions, D1 and D2, and there is a common H, as I draw here, U, and assume that the common piece is connected. And then we have a label on it, say P, and we shall look at the same label from D1. We shall denote it by P dash. Suppose that we start reading the region, the word R from this point, this direction. Then we can write down that P times Q, denote this part by me, and the Q is the label in D2 of me. Then we have that PQ equals R. This is one equation. Now suppose that we then certainly from the side of D1, P dash will not start here, because then we could cancel P1, D1 with D2. It will start in another point, say here. So we have now called this part H1. And this part T1. Then we have another equation saying that H1 P dash Q T1, sorry, equals R. And here I express the fact that P is a piece. Now I can have a diagram in which the C3 is not satisfied. This means that there exists a region which has two neighbors, exactly two neighbors, 1 and 2. So if I denote this by P, the label of this by P, the label of this by Q, then I get equations of the form PQ equals R. The fact that they are pieces means that they certainly will appear in a different occurrence along any of these regions, because here we use very heavily the fact that we have a single defining relator. So the label on each region is exactly the same. It only starts in a different point. Okay, so now I can write down the following set of equations. PQ equals R, H1 P dash T1 equals RR. I shall say a word on this. And H1 is not 1 or R. And the second equation is H2 Q dash T2 equals RR. Now, I do not really mean it is RR. I consider this as a cyclic word. And the equation is equation of cyclic words, not of linear words. Yes, because everything here must be considered a cyclic word. Now, this is a set of equations. It has a solution. And what I mean by being non-small cancellation in a complicated way, I mean that the way to solve this equation is long. I have many elementary operations to do, to carry out, in order to get to the solution. And then the theorem says that if the solution of this equation requires many elementary operations in order to get to the solution, then it will be a small cancellation in this generalized sense. And when this is not possible, then we shall get a finite set of words. Now, before going further, I would like to explain, and this is the main point here, that how can we know that we have only a finite set of exceptions. So the theorem will say, in a moment we shall see, it will say that if, as I say, the number of steps needed is long, then we shall get the small cancellation condition. So what is left? Left only the case when we have a small number, a non-small number of steps, which we have to do in order to get to the solution. And this is certainly finite, because I start with this equation. There are a very small number, in fact, two kind of elementary operations. And I carry out, say, at most 5. Then I have to check formally 2 to the fifth, 5 cases. In practice, is much, much less. And then I know that these are precisely all the words for which are suspected not to be small cancellation. So let us see this in more details. Okay, now I would like to show how I define this these partitions. Partitions which define the sequence of partitions. How to define these partitions? So first of all, you observe, it is trivial, that every partition defines the equivalence relation, and vice versa, every equivalence relation defines a partition. So we are going to define equivalence relations in the following way. I think that this way is very well known in general. The problem is how to carry it out. So the definition, I shall work out the definition of sigma 1. Sigma 2 and sigma 3 and so on are obtained in a similar way, but it is more complicated. Again, we have to say that something is not a piece, or is a piece, and then we have an equation, and we have to solve the equation, and if the way is long to the solution, then again, it will be small cancellation, and if not, then we can give the list. So, suppose that we have a subword W of R, I shall denote it by this symbol, and together with a decomposition delta naught of R into the following sequence, U1 W0, U2 W0, UK. It's an alternating sequence of words UI. UI are not one. And I would like to define an equivalence relation according to W naught. The idea is I define it the following way. I say that two adjacent regions, D1 and D2, are delta naught, W naught friends, if they have a common edge or connected component of the intersection. It has a common edge which contains an occurrence of W naught according to this decomposition. I shall call all the occurrences of W naught in this decomposition the W naught standard occurrences. Okay, so here there is a W naught. Of course, it very well may happen that there is much more than W naught. But now I consider D1 as the label R as a word in U1, W naught, U2, and up to UK. There is a technicality here. If I want to continue doing this inside the diagram, I have to cut out certain holes with labels which are one, which are freely equals to one, but they are a non-trivial word in the use. But doesn't matter, I shall skip this technicality. So consider the transitive closure of this relation is an equivalence relation. Transitive closure of delta naught W naught friendship is an equivalence relation. So it defines a partition, and I assume that all the parts, this I shall prove at the end, all the parts are these diagrams. So they define tau 1 to be the corresponding partition. Again, I say I assume at the moment that this partition is a disk partition, and it's a standard way to show if everything works correctly. Then there is a standard way to show that this is true by induction.
For the first step, you're going to take W0 to be the region that has only two neighbors.
Sorry?
For the first step, you're going to take W0 to be the region that has only two neighbors.
No, I didn't say this. No, I started in a different point. I have two adjacent regions. Mm-hmm. I look what is written here.
Yeah, but who's W0?
I shall tell in a moment. Okay? So this is a general construction. Mm-hmm. And then I shall tell you what are the W's. This is the point, how to choose them. Mm-hmm. Okay, so the two. Okay, so now consider that I have a subword, again, a refinement of this relation by the following. Suppose W naught has a subword W1 with a decomposition with a decomposition of R in the following way, say delta 1 gives R as the product of U1 upper 1, W1, U2, W2, UK1. W1 such that delta 1 is a refinement of delta naught. Yes, it is clear what is meant by this. And then I can continue this procedure, and finally I may get a sequence W naught containing W1, containing W2, containing K, having such a sequence of words. Each such word defines a partition of the diagram, and we get a sequence of partitions according to this, because this is the sequence of words is defined in a kind of nested way, and each one of them defines a equivalence relation, and each equivalence relation is a partition, and because this is a refinement, also the partitions will be one the refinement of the other. Okay? So we shall say that
the more refined partition, the delta, the less refined the, right? You're reversing the
diagrams will be larger. Mm-hmm. Yes, it's true. Okay, so now I have to say how I find these words W naught. And here is the main statement. Now, I call this equation that was written somewhere here, so maybe I write it down again. We have P Q equals R, and then we have H1 P dash T1 equals R. In fact, I mean this is the cyclic word R, and also I have H2 Q dash P2 equals R. I call such a system a two system. And I simply denote it by PQ P dash Q dash. In a sense, this such a system is a piecewise rotation, a finite analog of piecewise rotation, because if I consider P and Q, then P dash is obtained from P by a shift, and Q dash is also obtained by a shift. So this is such an analog of this rotation, but of course this is not the usual one, because everything here is finite. Okay, so two-system means that we have these three equations. Proposition, this is the main proposition. Sorry?
What are the unknowns?
The unknowns are P and Q.
And H?
H and T are you may also consider them as unknowns. There are no coefficients here.
Okay.
They are
prime
also...
Actually, I mean, P prime is sort of the same as P, right?
Of course. Yes. Just to point out that it is in a different place on the region. Yes, there are no coefficients. As we will see, I'm interested in P and Q. I shall not say anything on H and T because I don't need them. But they are equally the same situation as the P and the Q. They are variables. I don't use this fact anyway. No, I don't use this fact. What I need is not the solution. I need the way to the solution. So if you, just like in linear algebra, you have to want to solve the equation, you have a certain set of elementary operations, and the solution is just a normal form of obtained by these operations. What I need is exactly a particular sequence of elementary operations which lead to solution. There may be many other, but I need a special one which will give me what I need here. Okay? Okay. Yes, maybe after the lecture. So what is the main proposition? There exists a constructive, I shall explain how it is constructed, constructive sequence of elementary operations. Now, by elementary operations, as usual, I mean a shifting by the, what I draw here, by the difference between P and P dash, and shifting the other, the Q to Q dash. These are the elementary operations. Elementary operations, I have to choose what I do. Operations. Leading to the solution, leading to solution of one, this is the system one, with the following properties. Now, what is the problem with equations? Usually, we start with two variables, then we subdivide one of them or several of them, and again subdivide, and again subdivide. Number of variables may go very, very much, very big, and then it may go very small. But anyway, very quickly we'll lose all control on the number of variables. And also, what is the relationship between them? Now, the statement here says that it is not the situation in our case. Namely, we have at most, in fact, except two cases, we have exactly four variables at each step. Each step of the carrying out the elementary operations. So, at step I mean when I carry out the ith elementary operation, there are four variables. Not any number, but just four, which I denote by x, y, x star, dual of x, y star, such that x, y form a two system. So this means that I can again get back such situation, such equation, and I can repeat it again and again. But still, it doesn't solve the problem, because what happens to this x star and y star? They are not in an equation. At each step, I shall be left. See, xi. Sorry. At each step, I shall remain with two variables. Then, of course, this such a statement cannot be true. And the second thing is that the number of parts from these two systems, intersection with the number of parts in the next system, is 1. So one of these must subdivide in the next step. The other one may subdivide in very, very far from this point. Maybe this xi, say I is 10, then it says that one of them, either xi or yi, there is a procedure to decide which exactly, subdivides in the next step. But the other one, the yi, may subdivide after the 200 steps. And then it will remain all the way along unchanged. Okay, and the third, when this is the main part, let zi be xi if xi decomposes completely at step I plus 1. So here we see that one of them should decompose in the next step. And let zi equals yi if yi decomposes at step I plus 1. Then z0, z1, z2, zk is a system, is a sequence such that the corresponding, so remember that each such word we have seen here defines an equivalence relation, and each equivalence relation is a partition. So looking at such a sequence, we have a sequence of partitions. Yes, and such that the corresponding partitions, say call them tau I, corresponding to the zi, is small zi plus 1, is thin relative, tau k is thin relative to tau naught. So it, either way, it means that tau k is thin, which means that its dual is a tree. So this is the first statement. And now, how we define sigma 1? We define sigma 1, definition of sigma 1, we simply define sigma 1 to be tau k. So this means that we have the first subdivision will be into tree-like or thin subdiagrams. What about the second one? So how we define the second one? This will be sigma 1, the first one in this sequence. Sigma 2 is defined, again, corresponding to an equation. It turns out that easy to see that R has a conjugate which can be written in the form W alpha 1 AB W alpha K alpha R AB, when A and B in A are words such that HA, first letter of H, is different from the first letter of B, and A is cyclic conjugate, and I denote by W alpha the word AB alpha A. It's easy to see. So now what is this next step? First, we have the the theorem, the following theorem. If NR, that is the K, if K greater or equal 4, then sigma 2 is a, so sigma 2 is a C6 relative to sigma 1. So sigma 1 was the regions in sigma 1 were this these tree-like sub-diagrams, and sigma 2 is the following. I take now the division according to the word W equals to A. So I consider each, consider R as a word in two letters, A and B, and I glue along A and B in a standard position, in the position that is here. Yes? And this is the, this is what I get for the, for sigma 2. And then the theorem says that if K greater or equal 4, then taking this as regions the, coming from sigma 1, we get a diagram which is C6. So what is left? What happens if K is less than 4? But then we know that all we have to do is to go in this in the solution of this, it was written here, of this equation, at most three steps. And we know exactly how to do this, because we can go along this, this is the main point, we can go along these two steps, which somehow disappear. And this we know how to do. So we get finally a sequence, a set, a small set of words in A and B, which may be the maybe the non-small cancellation words. And for them, I have to do by ad hoc calculations to see whether they are small cancellation or maybe they are something else. For example, not for this case, for if I go to C4, not C4 is not satisfied, then I get the following word, ABA, ABABA, A, B, A, B, A, B, A. And this word is not a small cancellation word. This is just the Banstock solitaire B1 minus 2. So here I can see that although this word is quite long, it is a Banstock solitaire. So for certainly I cannot draw a diagram, a small cancellation diagram for this. However, what I can do, I have these regions. Inside this region, I have Banstock solitaire. But then if I consider each of them as a region, I get a diagram which is small cancellation. So if I want to use this method, I have to do much more in order to use it. Or I can, and I know what is the structure theory of the group B12. For example, I want to solve the conjugacy problem or something else, I have to know how to solve conjugacy in B12 and in small cancellation groups. And from these two, I can get, it's much more work, it is far from being done, I can get a method which enables us to deal with non-small cancellation one relator groups. By the way, it works also for free products and with some limitations for amalgamated free products. And the reason is that everything here is word combinatorics. And for free products, there is well-developed word combinatorics, and everything goes through. Thank you.
Questions?
Thank you.
And we meet again at 1:15.